P-40 Warhawk. On December 7, 1941, it was part of that thin line of fighters based throughout the Pacific. A few got into the air at Pearl Harbor, but its lasting fame was earned by less than 100 P-40s flown in China by the Flying Tigers. Before disbanding in 1942, they shot down 286 Japanese planes while losing only 8 P-40s in aerial combat. The P-40 wasn't the fastest airplane we had in World War II, and it wasn't the most maneuverable. But it was a very special machine to all those that flew it. And it was a special machine to me, too. That's why I like to fly it today. I'm Colonel Joe Engle. I'm an Air Force astronaut assigned to the Space Shuttle Program. The P-40 was just one of the remarkable flying machines of World War II. Fortunately, for all of us in the Air Force, this part of our heritage has been preserved as it actually was. It's been preserved by a group of Americans who, simply for love of these old airplanes and the spirit they represent, have formed the Confederate Air Force. They've collected at least one of nearly every American combat airplane that flew during the war, and a few from our allies and former enemies. World War II saw the most rapid advances in aviation to that time. Fighter aircraft leaped forward in both design and capability. Planes like this P-38 Lightning, easily the most recognizable fighter of the war. But its performance was even more unforgettable. The P-38 brought down more Japanese planes than any other American aircraft. Along with the P-40 and the P-38, there was also the P-51 Mustang and the P-47 Thunderbolt, the Judd. They helped make long-range bombing more effective. While they did that, bombers like this grand old lady, the B-17 Flying Fortress, were creating their own history and their own legends. The B-17 was the mainstay of American long-range bombers throughout the war. They brought enormous destruction on enemy military and industrial facilities. There were other heavy and medium bombers, though. The versatile B-24 Liberator, the B-25 Mitchell, Jimmy Doolittle fame, and, of course, the bomber that brought World War II to an abrupt conclusion, the B-29 Superfortress. It's a living history that's been preserved here. And once each year, the Confederate Air Force puts on the air show of all air shows. war couldn't have been won without these aircraft. They tell their story in the exploits of those that flew them. It was a remarkable time in the history of air power. It was a time to remember.